Okay, third and fourth graders, welcome back. We are going to be finishing up lesson three today. Yesterday we were on the Wright family, how the mother earned money as a photographer. The father went back to school to become a manager and make more income. And then the son James earned money by doing chores around the house. And we started off with how they spend their money. So the three main things that you should be spending your money on is food, clothing, and shelter. And then after that, you can do all the fun expenses. So they spent their money on James for fun by giving him karate lessons. Sorry, and James could even spend his own income on maybe purchasing something fun that he would have wanted. Now we're going to look at how you can save money, because an important part of earning money is also being able to save. To have money available should something arise, like a flat tire or somebody gets hurt and has to go to the doctor, then you have money set aside to help you out with those major expenses. And you could also have some money set aside for something special that to purchase, or maybe a vacation for everybody. So saving money, I am on page 429. The money the Wrights save is called their savings. They deposit or put their savings into a bank. A savings account in a bank earns interest. Interest is the money a bank pays people for keeping their money there. It is also the money a person pays to borrow money. Banks loan to other people some of the money. Banks loan to other people some of the money deposited in savings accounts. Those people often borrow that money to start businesses or to buy houses. They pay interest to the bank until all the money is paid back. The Wrights also invest some of their money. To invest is to buy something that will grow in value. One kind of investment involves buying a small part of another person's business. The Wrights hope to make more money when the businesses grow. A lot of people will try to do that if they have a little bit of extra money, because if you invest in something, then you might be able to get a little bit of money back. And sometimes there are some investments that are considered high risk, and people will invest a lot of money in a risky situation to be able to get a lot of money, even more money back. You kind of have to do what's on your comfort level with that. Some people also purchase houses as an investment, because then you're not paying rent at an apartment or a rent for a house that you're not actually owning. But if you own a house, it is also considered an investment. Okay. A family makes a budget. The Wright family keeps a budget. A budget is a plan for spending and saving money. To make a budget, the Wrights first list the ways they earn money. Next, they write down each family member's job. Next to each job, they write the income from it. This part of the budget tells them how much money they have to spend or save. The Wrights then list the ways they spend money. They organize their list. Okay, so the Wrights had to make a list of the money that they are bringing in. Then they list the ways they spend the money. They organize their list into five groups: shelter, food and clothing, fun, giving, and savings. They add up all the amounts of money they spend for different things. Then they write the total for each group. The Wrights family budget helps them see how they spend their money. It also helps them make plans to reach economic goals. Reaching those goals. The Wrights want to take a camping trip. They will need to buy a tent and other supplies before they go. Their budget shows them how much money they can save each week. This lets them see when they will have enough money for camping supplies. If the Wrights follow their budget, they will reach their goal. So budgeting is all about making sure that you're keeping track of the money you make minus the money that you need to spend for certain things, to see how much money you have left to maybe play with, like they want to do with camping, so they can go and purchase the supplies, the tent, and go on that trip. It might take them a while, it might not take them a while. It really depends on how much money they have coming in. What you are going to do now is go to Google Classroom and work on the activity that I have there. And I want you to be talking with your parents about what their budget looks like. If they have a way to include you in that as well, would be very helpful. Next week, we're going to be taking a look at how you can... So go ahead and take a look on Google Classroom for that, and be ready for next week to take a look at the budgeting things we're going to be practicing with so that you get the idea of how to manage money. All right, talk to you later.